off me, you damn dirty ape!
If you could see out through my eyes, you wouldn't wonder at all. If you could see out through my eyes, I guarantee you would fall like I did when we're in public together. I hear society moan, but if they could see out through my eyes, maybe they'd leave us alone.
In a word, when I mention Planet of the Apes, what comes to your mind?
Swiftonian satire.
Swiftonian satire?
Not science fiction.
The idea of switching the killers of the apes and the, you know, standing with their guns and with their foot on the human being. That's kind of funny.
Smile.
I think it was on the Supreme Court of the monkey Supreme Court, the monkey court.
Dr. Zero, would you tell Bright Eyes to be quiet?
My name is Taylor.
Hit it! Silence the animal!
Science fiction is creating a reality that doesn't really exist. I mean, there is no Planet of the Apes. But the first one was Frank Schaffner was directing, and it's of its kind. It created a whole genre.
The responsible elements in making that picture acceptable was the production design, the costuming, and the makeup. Because what the makeup did was allow those actors to use their mouths, work the nose, and above all, did not take away from that cinematic element again, which was the eyes. You could read the eyes of the actors, and that was enormously important.
Not fell, flew.
Flight is a scientific impossibility.
And even if it weren't, why fly?
The makeup took a long time, 2 hours in the morning. I remember Kim Hunter, who played one of, I guess, the chimp, and poor darling sitting in the makeup chair, and a tear just rolled down her cheeks. She'd been sitting there for, you know, 2 or 3 hours putting these appliances on.
And they would have to have their lunch through a straw, and it's claustrophobic to have something on your face like that, and when it begins itching, you're just dying to tear that away. I don't know how they did it. I couldn't have done it myself.
I remember when they had the cast and crew screening, and I saw this handsome woman, and she said, "Chuck, how are you?" And I said, I'm sorry, help me." And she said, it's Kim Hunter." And of course, she played the ape scientist.
"Doctor, I'd like to kiss you goodbye."
And I had never seen her without the makeup, never. And I'd only seen her as the ape.
"All right, but you're so damned ugly."
I'm not certain that too much isn't known about the making of movies. Part of the great joy to me is like going into a movie theater and being able to surrender yourself to this gigantic thing that's up there. I don't want to know too much about how the film was made until maybe 50 years later. Then I'm fascinated by it.
None of us knew that it was going to be such a hit.
What a hit, yeah.
Or we judge it to be the picture that would be moderately successful at best, and at worst would be rejected by the viewers.
A day or so after the first opening, when they were actually had people going to the movie, Dick Zanuck called me, and he said, "Chuck, you have no idea the legs this picture is going to have." He said, "It may be the most successful film we have ever made at Fox. I got to do another film. I got to do a sequel." I said, "Oh, come on, Dick. This is the movie. It's a great idea, and we've made a good movie out of a great movie. And but that's it. I said, we don't want it. I said, he said, we have to do it. And I can't do it if you're not in it. And I said, how about if you kill me in the first scene? He said, how about if you disappear in the first scene and you get killed in the last scene? I said, that's pretty slick, Dick. But I said, that's actually good.
Were you surprised that Planet of the Apes kept on coming back in different forms?
Not at all. Not at all. No, no, no. It was great. Now, and usually the sequels are never quite as good as the others. No. I'm not really surprised by much anymore.
And then you got a chance to play the ape in Tim Burton's Rethinking.
Yes, indeed.
How was it to be on the other side of the species?
Well, it was an easy thing to do because I was dying, and all actors love death scenes, and I got to do a great death scene. The makeup took about 3 hours to put on and almost an hour to take off. So it wasn't my favorite day, but it was an okay scene.
Form of the Visions! Form of the Visions!